Duduzile Zuma Sambundla accuses the ANC to say these are the people that are destabilizing MK from within, and ANC have responded to that. So I want us to dive deep into that and unpack that for a bit. Now, before you get probably lost or you accuse me of maybe probably losing you, let me explain it in a language that you can understand. Let me give you a bit of things that happened in the past. Now, you will remember there was a man called Ojablan Khumalo who was tasked with the responsibility of registering EMK and never revealed that it's from Zuma, and he himself has said it. And then that man registered MK party, and then he stepped down, and then people came and say, oh, you stepped down. No. The MK party is yours. We got to hear, through unverified sources, that the ANC penetrated EMK using Ojablan Khumalo. That's the reason that prompted as well in another language, we call it the disfellowshipped, if you are a church member. But they cut their losses. MK party chased them away. It was three of them that they couldn't justify where they got the money to buy. Ojablan Khumalo bought a 2 million rand car, which was the Land Cruiser what, and then bought two houses, one in Palito and the other one. They couldn't justify where that money was coming from. But according to the intelligence, which we get to know, it was coming from ANC, right? They were asked, and we got to know with unverified sources, so let's say allegedly as well, that the person that was instrumental in doing that, it was Zweli Mkhize, allegedly. So with that being said, there's that history and that suspicions. Now, when Duduzile Zuma accuses ANC of penetrating MK, destabilizing MK from within, you must remember now the context that I've just given you. So ANC then respond and say, no, Tinawe did not do it. Tinawe did not destabilize MK from within. It's not us. You know what I'm saying? Now I'm going to ask you a very simple, basic, yet fundamental question. Do you even believe that they didn't do it? You know, I'm not saying they did it because we don't have a proof. Did not go to court and it was proven in court. But I'm just asking, just on a general note, do you believe that, as they say, they did not do it? So we're about to get into these details where ANC, they are saying, MK party, please, you've got a tendency of accusing us over things that we did not do. This one, no, it's not us. We did not do this one. Please. Not today. We should have a figure in Balula. I also want to tell you the fact that we are on our journey to 60,000 subscribers. So it will help us, you know, if you were to do the right thing. And the right thing is this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. All right. So let's dive into this one, right? Let's dive into this one. ANC acting spokesperson Zoko Godlimpi has dismissed the claim by MK Party and MK Party member Duduzile Zuma Sambundla that the party is behind MK Party's leadership trouble by attempt to infiltrate and unstrap the power. Zuma Sambundla accused the ANC of having a hand in criticism she has faced from MK Party members. Okay. Hey, the allegation sounds very, 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 very strong. Those who have agendas will always see me and other loyal local comrades as a threat and obstacles to wreak havoc, and that is fine. If protecting the MK party means wreaking havoc, then wreaking havoc shall it be local, shall be towards the vultures, those aim as to hijack the party or kill the organization. Now, let me also put you into context and remind you of something. Do you remember that the ANC were accused of doing a similar thing to ATM? Do you remember that? I forgot that, but I did a video. You can go through this channel, previous videos. The ANC have been accused of similar incident to ATM. So these accusations, they seem to follow the party. The question is, why are they struggling from similar accusations? Her remarks were a reference to an article by Sunday World, which claims she was causing division within the party veteran association. She shifted the blame to the ANC. There has been a lot of unidentified individuals of the ANC who have tried and continue to infiltrate MK Party to assert power to themselves in a plan to take over the MK Party through strategical deployed agent and in so doing attempt to discredit me, Busho Usambundla Ududuzile Zuma. Now, again and again, I did that video. I did that article, which comes from East Sunday World. I told you that they've been saying that Duduzile Zuma is destroying the MK party from within. You know what I'm saying? So I did that article. If you want that video, you will look at a video that I think it is titled Duduzile Zuma Accused of Trying to Destroy the MK party from within. Right? So, speaking to Times Live, Godlimbi said the ANC had no interest in the MK party matters. The ANC must not be used as a scapegoat for internal mechanism and other parties. We are too busy focusing on governing the republic. The ANC has no interest in who does what, with whom, and when other parties say it. Oh. Okay. All right. Let me not go to the ATM story. They will accuse me of... But let me not go there. Report of emerged that Duduzile Zambudla has been controlling the party. Sunday World reported that she has been behind the acts of some of its leaders. Zuma Zambudla has been seen as Zuma's right-hand person since... he jumped ship from the ANC to join the MK party. That's what they are saying. But again, let me defend her for a moment. And I want to say this. Duduzile Zuma has been wherever Jacob Zuma is. So if before the formation of MK party, I'll tell you this. May I saw them with my own naked eyes. When they came to Zonke Zizwe, when Zuma was still a member of the ANC, he visited Zonke Zizwe. Zuma visited the church the venue that Zuma used is my church. At that time, I used to worship there. So I'm the guy that was preparing for Zuma for Zuma's arrival with the members of the intelligence department and members of the VIP protection that were busy making sure that they are not threatening the building and all the stuff. It is safe for Zuma to use it there because there's this team that usually arrive first. I'm the one that was working with those guys. They came with dogs and everything. Guess what? When Zuma arrived, guess who was there? Duduzile. In fact, way before the formation of MK Party, Duduzile has always been next to Zuma. So I'm surprised now when they say, oh, she's the right wing of MK Party. Before MK Party was... Jacob Zuma and Duduzile Zuma, wherever they appeared, Amata Nolim. So we can't now entertain a narrative that seeks to say, she's going to take over power. She's the right hand of Zuma. She's been doing it before. We did not complain. Why are we complaining now? Now that there's MK Party. Guys, let's be fair to other people. I'm not saying she won't do it, but I'm saying the idea that just because she's the closest to Zuma, we paint it as if it's a new thing. These two have been close before the formation of MK Party. Let them not be separated because there's MK formation part. Zuma is, because that's what Jabulani Khumalo said. Zuma is preparing her daughter. Fine. If that's what she's, look, Zuma is doing. What is it a crime for Zuma to do that? Right. Come on, is it a crime? No, I don't think so. Kheza Motaung has done it. Has prepared his children to take over Ikhaza Chiefs, right? Though they haven't been winning for 9 years, but the fact is, has been preparing his children. He knows how to sort out things because he's building a legacy for himself. Now, to those who are Christians, you must know there's a verse in the Bible that says a righteous man leave inheritance for his children's children, right? So as I'm living right now, I am building whatever I'm building for my children and for my children's children, right? It's about legacy, guys. A man within his super sound senses leaves legacy for his children. Mam kids, Royal AM is Royal Andilem Pisan. That football team is for Andilem Pisan. Why we don't have a problem with it? Oh, because it's MK Party, we want to find faults, right? There are ANC. Who are their funders? We don't ask such questions. Who is funding ANC? Why are we channeling energy to MK Party? We want to know the ownership of MK Party. Oh, if Zuma died, who's going to be the owner? Guys, the relationship that we have with MK Party is not about ownership. It's about the service delivery. As long as MK Party delivers what it promised, the relationship with MK Party should end there. Who's becoming the owner and what? It's none of our business, because we do not invest the same energy when it comes to ANC. Who's the founder? We want to know into details. Why are we so fixated upon MK Party, but we don't use the same energy to ANC? We should be asking the same question. ATM, we want to know all your funders. We're not. We are invested in MK Party. You have to do the Zuma. When Zuma is going to mean, when you're too close, you're going to be the next president. We don't care. We don't give a damn, not even a swimming pool. She is the next president or not. Our relationship with her, with the MK Party, is on the basis of service delivery. Owned or not owned, funded by Russia, as long as MK Party delivers service delivery, our relationship ends there. Full stop. Let's make the number one priority the number one priority. Let's keep it like that, right? Do not allow media to tell you to create narratives. Zuma, hey, now if you build a company, you want your children to run. It's a wish of every parent to be succeeded by their children. I'm being honest, guys. If I'm building my media company, I want my children to succeed me. It is happening. Kheza Motaung is doing it. Mam Kheza is doing it. We can name a lot of people in South Africa, right? People who, I remember meeting the child for this company, it's called Glad Africa. It used to sponsor the second division. The child is into construction, the father is into construction. The child is inspired by the father. What's wrong with it? There is nothing wrong with that, right? Petrus Motsepe. We see Dr. Petrus Motsepe, their children now, they are involved in Mamelodi Sundowns and other projects. But the person who started a lot of things is Petrus Motsepe. Now his children and family are involved in the business. We don't say, why when Hope Motsepe, you are involved in Sundowns. We don't say that. Why do we have a problem with MK Party? Yo. We want to stick our nose in other people's business. It's not our business who owns MK Party. Stick to your business. Your business is to go and build your own company. I'm definitely sure you will want your children to be involved in it. Why do you have a problem with MK Party being owned by Duduzile Zuma? Duduzile Zuma or Duduzane Zuma? Is it a problem? Mina is not a problem who owns what. Let's not complicate matters, because most of you don't even know who's the funders of ANC. You don't know into details. You're just listening to media. Do not allow media to tell you what, to create, to give you their mind. Use your brain. Your problem or your relationship with MK Party is service delivery. Your relationship with ANC is service delivery. ATM, EFF, you name them. Your relationship with those political parties is service delivery, not ownership. Forget about it. It's not your relationship with ownership. Whether Malema owns EFF, he doesn't own EFF, is none of your business. EFF, your relationship with EFF is service delivery. As long as EFF delivers on its mandate, it should end there. Do not complicate matters. PA, well, have you ever heard a person maybe questioning Uguti? Hi, why is Gaitin Mackenzie a PA? Oh, it's from prison. Why is it? Does it matter? The constitution allowed that Gaitin Mackenzie should participate there and look in parliament because he has served his 5 years. What? Former thieves or whatever you want to call them, ex convict, whatever you want to call them, right? We don't question things like that because it's none of our business. Our business with our PAC, Patriotic Alliance, PAS, is the relationship you have with them. Have you ever had a person questioning who owns PA? Nobody questions that. Why? Even if it is owned by Gaitin Mackenzie and the Silent Partners, it's not a big deal. It's not your problem. Nizofa, mbula wengi nga melang, es ngan fag, angeni ndao lapo nina. AmaZulu, that's got its owner. There was a man there that, I forgot the name of that guy. He's a brother to Sandile Zungu, who owns AmaZulu right now. They were working there together. Is it a problem? That guy has a serious position there. Is it a problem? No. Orlando Pirate, there was a member of, I forgot the position that they were serving in. Just because the companies, look, Orlando Pirate, the chairman is Khoza, is it a problem? Jomo Cosmos, the son, Bamuza Son, he used to play for Jomo Cosmos. It is his father's team. Why should it be a problem? Why is nepotism? Why is Jomo Bamuza Son playing for Jomo Son? Hey, he's playing for his father's team. What's the problem with it? Your relationship with that team is not on the basis of who look at the biological connections. No, your relationship is watching football. And if Jomo Sono promise you that it's going to give you entertaining football, your problem with Jomo Sono is not on the relationship, it's not on the basis of the biological connection of the players, is on the basis of delivering good football to you. As long as Jomo Sono delivers football, good football to you, you should be satisfied and you should end there. Do not go now and ask questions that are not your business. Not your business to know who, look, biological connections. There are a lot of people who own big businesses and take their families to participate in those businesses. The list goes on and on. I've never had a person complaining about why is Royal AM called Royal AM? It's Royal Andelebisa. Ungenap. Umam Kiza bought it for Andile when ungenap. If you are following Royal AM, your relationship with Royal AM is on the basis of football and what they deliver on the pitch. The rest, the ownership, I'm not successful. Imedia izonenza ukuthi niyekele indaba zabantu busy ngkati MK. Mina nginamsebenzi nokuthi ubani one-MK. It's none of my business. Why should it be your business, vele? As long as MK delivers on its mandate, done. The rest, we don't care. We don't give a damn. Not even a swimming pool. Patriotic Alliance is owned by Kenny Nene, who was once a thief. So what? Does it mean that he doesn't have a right to own local Patriotic Alliance? The constitution allows, of course. So own as much as you can political parties. As long as you deliver on the mandate promised. Why not? Have you ever asked a person a question? Who owns Pick and Pay? Why the owner of Pick and Pay owns the boxer? We don't ask that. Our relationship with the supermarket is not on the basis of ownership. is on the basis of look of service delivery. Whatever they promise, they deliver. We're good. Right? Maybe the issues of land and all the stuff will come in when it comes to those supermarkets, but in general, the relationship we have with them is on the basis of service delivery. That they promise to sell good product to us and we promise to buy it. It ends there. We have never questioned the ownership of Pick and Pay, ShopRite and everything. Why are we questioning the ownership of MK Party? Do not allow media to mislead you.